We want to match each equation or function with the correct graph. The point of this question is not to graph the functions using technology and then match the function to the graph. The point is to recognize the type of function transformation that has occurred.
Remember, if we have a transformation of the square root function,
we can write the function in the form of f of x equals a times the square root of the product of b and the quantity x minus c plus d, where the values of a, b, c, and d determine the type of transformation. For a quick review, A indicates a vertical stretch or compression, B indicates a horizontal stretch or compression, C indicates a horizontal shift, and D indicates a vertical shift. You may want to pause the video and review these notes in detail. Let's begin by identifying the values of A, B, C, and D for each of the functions. For the first function, notice A equals 2, which indicates a vertical stretch. For the second function, we have c equals positive 2, which indicates a shift right 2 units. In comparison, notice for the third function, c is negative 2, because x minus negative 2 does simplify to x plus 2. This indicates a shift left 2 units. For the fourth function, even though we have 2 in the front, d equals positive 2, which indicates a vertical shift up 2 units. For the fifth function, because the coefficient of x is 2, we have b equals 2. This indicates a horizontal compression by a factor of 1 divided by b, or in our case, 1 half. And then finally, for the last function, we have d equals negative 2, which indicates a shift down 2 units. It may be helpful to find two key points on the basic square root function graphed above to better recognize the type of transformation. For example, let's use the point 0, 0 and 4, 2. For the first function, where a equals 2, we have a vertical stretch by a factor of 2, which affects the y values. To find the corresponding points on the transformed function, we would multiply the y values by 2, which would give us 0, 0 and 4, 4. Looking at the six graphs, though, only one shows a vertical stretch by a factor of 2, which is this first graph. Notice it does pass through 0, 0 as well as 4, 4. For the second function, because c is positive 2, the graph has been shifted right 2 units, which affects the x values. We would add 2 to the x values, or just analyzing the functions, notice only one of them is a square root function shifted right 2 units, which is graph c. For the third function, we have c equals negative 2, and therefore the square root function is shifted left 2 units, which analyzing the remaining graphs, we can see is graph E, where the square root function has been shifted left 2 units. For the fourth function, D is positive 2, which indicates the square root function has been shifted up 2 units. If we wanted to find points on the graph, we would add 2 to the y values, which would be 0, 2 and 4, 4, which analyzing the remaining graphs would be graph D. It passes through 0, 2 and 4, 4, or just recognizing this is the graph of the square root function shifted up 2 units. Let's go ahead and jump down to the last function where d is negative 2, which indicates a vertical shift down 2 units. Notice graph f is the basic square root function shifted down 2 units, which leaves us with the remaining function and graph B, where B equals positive 2, which indicates a horizontal compression by a factor of 1 half, the reciprocal of B. This would affect the x values. To find the corresponding points on the transformed function, we would multiply the x values of the basic square root function by 1 half, which notice would give us 0, 0 and 2, 2, because 1 half times 4 is 2. And looking at the remaining graph, notice how it does pass through 0, 0, as well as 2, 2. And hopefully we can visualize, if we were to compress the basic square root function
horizontally by a factor of 1 half,
it would resemble the shape of graph B. I hope you found this helpful.